very interesting table that I'm going to show you just now, also important one, and one should really realize that this is very significant and important table for the existence of Israel. Yeah, as you will see why. So, as one who knows a little bit Gemara, Talmud, Medrash, Torah knows quite well that the problems that Israel had from the Amalekites, always wanted to wipe them out. That's the meaning of the word Amalek, means Amlak, the nation wants to lick the Jewish blood like a dog. So, and there, our rabbis bring us few interesting and important reasons why Amalekites come to attack and to fight with Israel. Now, one of them is, which is brought in the Medrash, that when few Jews, Datan and Aviram, desecrated the Sabbath, then immediately afterwards the Torah says, Vayavo Amalek, Vayelachem im Israel. Amalek came to fight with Israel. It was a very, very strong fight, and our rabbis tell us that Moses was sitting on a stone there, and when he lifted his hands, Israel overcame. Then he brought them down. It was the opposite. Definitely does not mean that it depends on his hands, but when Israel had faith, belief in God, then they won. But they did not have. That. Unfortunately, the Amalekite won. You will see it exactly in the place when we found the desecration of Shabbos and the fought with Amalek. I think with Amalek, amazing how it comes together. Then there is another reason, quite famous also, that the reason that Amalek came to fight with Israel was Rephidim. The place Rephidim is Raf Yadayim. Their hands were loose in keeping the Torah. Another time is written, when the Jews ask question, is God with us? Is not with us? Came Amalek to remind them there is a God with them. So let us see a very interesting table about this. So this is the table which is coming just now and shows you about this connection with Amalekite and the desecration of Shabbos. So what we see in this table is the following. Unbelievable. I was looking for what our sages tell us, the Chilul Shabbat in black, the desecration of Shabbos, and Amalek. It came exactly in this war when Amalek had fought with Israel, and the story is in the Torah, Kasher Yaniach Yadoven, Moses brought down his hands, Gavar Amalek. Amalek was winning, overcoming. Amazing. This is the story, you know, the heaven put a stone, and then Moses was sitting. So, amazing, it comes exactly when, you know, the end of Moses was done. Jews did not believe, did not have strong faith. And Amalek was overwinning, he was overcoming. And amazing, it comes exactly in these verses, when the Torah says, Me'amtem lishmo mitzvotai v'torotai, you refuse to guard, to keep my mitzvot and my Torah. Re'u, look, observe, ki Hashem natam lachem ha-shabbos, God gave you the Shabbos, which is the basis of faith in God, the creation. Our Rebbe said that Shabbos is so important, like all the Torah together. Amazing, comes here. And here the Torah says clearly, when you refuse to keep my mitzvot Torah, when you desecrate the Shabbos, came Amalek. And exactly this is what is going on in Israel. Unfortunately, from time to time, more cities like Tel Aviv, Ramat Gan, other Kfar Saba ones, to desecrate the Shabbos. And we see more and more troubles, more and more terror, and more balance. And who knows what will be with Iran, which is waiting now for opportunity to fight Israel. Here you have Iran, parallel, and oh yeah, parallel. And one should know the parallel is not simple. If you come parallel, oh yeah, enemy and Iran, far away from being really coincidence. Also you have here this year, 5,780, and this really, if you are the news in Israel, almost everyone says that very likely it will be a war. So let us see now what we have more here, very important. We have Ishmael, and if you remember, we saw and we mentioned what Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer, chapter of Rabbi Eliezer, said more than 2,000 years, that Ishmael, which means God will listen in future, is because the Arabs, the descendants of Ishmael, will do so many troubles to Jews, killing, murdering, wounding, what we see today, that Israel will pray and will realize that only God can help them, and Ishmael and God will listen to their prayer, to their prayers, to their crying. This was exactly why Ishmael, and Ishmael is the Islam, and Iran definitely part of it, no doubt. So this problem that Israel, which you have Israel, you know, who are desecrating the Shabbos, they bring upon them a lot of troubles. And who knows that if these troubles, the war can come out from Iran, very likely, will bring Israel to Teshuvah, which comes here, to repentance. And our rabbis really tell us that in Sanhedrin chapter Chelek, that if Jews would not do Teshuvah willingly, so God will appoint a very cruel leader upon them, like Haman, and today we have Hamani, and he will really threaten Israel, and we know the more than 100,000 misas, and then people forget about it, and this can chas v'shalom wipe Israel. So hoping that Israel will do Teshuvah, will not desecrate the Shabbos, which is the root to source to all of their troubles, as our rabbis tell us, and will have Messiah coming soon and redeem us and bring peace and tranquility to the whole world.